It's July, and that means one thing. Time to pack up the gear and head up to one of my favorite places on Earth. That place is the Ottawa River, and I'm going to fish with one of the best musky guides out there, John Anderson. John is owner and operator of the Ottawa River Musky Factory in Plantagenet, Ontario. This is going to be my third time up to that part of the river, and let's just say, I have yet to be disappointed. As usual, I'm taking a trek with my best friend and fellow musky hunter, Rob Gabriel. Gabe hunts hard, hunts often, and has the scrapbook to show that he knows a thing or two about these toothy apex predators. So between the three of us, I'm hoping this third time up truly is a charm. If you were to ask me, what would be your prime choice for fishing conditions? Invariably, I would say to you, overcast skies, cooler temps, prefrontal conditions, all during a major moon phase. As luck and a little bit of forethought in our planning last year would have it, these were the exact conditions we were working with as we set out for our first day on the water. It came as no surprise when, within the first hour of day one, Gabe connected with a fish on his topwater bait. And I'm standing there thinking, is this 2016 all over again?
Welcome back, team.
Little male.
Unfortunately for the boat, it was certainly not 2016 all over again. We spent roughly the next 10 hours casting our asses off, with not so much as even the suggestion of a muskie. Finally, as we were nearing the end of the day, Gabe yet again came through and hooked into a scrappy little muskie that was hell-bent on performing an aerial display for us. So as the sun set on day one, I have to say, I was a bit surprised. I thought for sure we would have seen more than just those two small fish. Oh wait, I forgot that this happened earlier that day.
There he is! Ah, I lost it!
Day two started out a little more precariously. Storm cells were hovering around the entire area, and the night before, a massive front moved through, dumping tons of water on the area, churning up tributary rivers, and causing an inflow of milk chocolatey-looking mud-filled water into the Ottawa, lessening the clarity of an already difficult fishing situation. We tried everything, spot after spot after spot, all with the same result. The fish were simply not interested this morning. While the weather may have changed by the time we made it out for the second half of day two, our luck with muskies didn't. We fished upriver, we fished downriver, and they just weren't having it. In fact, the only action any of us saw that day was when I had a fish follow my bucktail in. Day two was in the books, and we were going home blank. Our third and final day had arrived, and seemingly so did the wind and more rain. With the funk of the prior day hopefully behind us, we set out again. For the next 4 hours, we pounded spot after spot, with the only thing to show for it being the smallest fish of the trip thus far. With only about an hour or so of daylight left, the reality of the situation began to set in. Did we really travel all this way for 3 30-inch class fish, and me with only a follow? It seemed ridiculously unbelievable. And then, it happened.
No, that's not it. We're on the other side.
Gabe pitched a bucktail tight to some weeds and hooked into what he considers to be the best fish of his career thus far.
As soon as I threw it right on its head. Right on its head. Alright, I'm shaking like a leaf.
Front of the boat for picks?
Yeah.
So I go home empty-handed, and Gabe goes home with a trophy. Is that frustrating? Is that unfair? Nope. That's musky hunting. And I can't wait to get back up there next year.